Bonjour à la communauté, j'espère que vous allez tous bien. Today I'm going to do something different. I don't know if what I'm going to do, I'm going to do in French or English because that kind of confused me. Because the guy I want to talk to today is from Togo. He's one of my good cousin. He's been living in the States for a while and he do something amazing. And I want to share what he does and I was so blessed to have this opportunity to talk about him today, about what he's doing. His name is F.E.M SATTY, and he's the owner of F.E.M Entreprise. He got enterprise where he take care of, I'm gonna say home improvement. He do the home improvement. Yeah. And the amazing thing too is like, he just have his new baby. You can see that? He have his new baby. I'm so proud, I'm so happy to share that with you. And I'm here to talk about F.E.M, about what he's doing and to know more about his book. Why inspiration he got to bring this book out, and he got stuff too. And I don't want to talk too much. And we're gonna let F.E.M talk about what he's doing and to know more about F.E.M. Time to time, like I say in my channel, we're gonna start speak English because we got a lot of English speaking friends who try to follow us. And at the same time, we're gonna try to see and show to people what we do as community, as African, what we do in America. Sometimes people think, most of the time, what people think about us, about African people, is bad thing. But we're gonna try to prove them we are not bad people, and we try to do good things too, and we got good people among our community too. Then I hope you're gonna enjoy this video. Hey, F.E.M, happy to see you again.
Happy to see you. How are you?
I'm good. I hope you're doing great, right?
I'm doing super fantastic. Yeah. That's my own world.
Yeah, I'm so happy because you give me this opportunity to come to your place, talk to you about what you're doing. And I'm so happy. I think I'm the first one trying to speak about your book, right?
Yeah, you are the first
one. The best one.
You're the best one. Hey, it happened to find me, so I'm glad to have you. Hey, it's an honor for me to have you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
I think people will know more about you. Yeah. Who is F.E.M? How can we know you?
Well, when you say F.E.M, let's say my full name is OLou-Femy SATTY. F.E.M is an entrepreneur, let's just put it that way. I'm an entrepreneur, and I am also owner of F.E.M Entreprises, LLC. Yes, what we do is focus on home improvement and also our personal life maintenance. Like I say, when you look at my flag, I say it is.
Oh, your flag, this one?
Yes, you see, you a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah, when you look underneath of it, we say, yeah, personal life maintenance. That's what we do. I'm the one that come to your home and make your home beautiful as you desire, but we just want to stay there. We want to go to also our personal, what we have inside. Because for the outside to be really how we want it, we got to take care of the inside. That's where I'm coming from. That's basically.
I mean, if I get what you're saying, is like you take care of people's house.
Yeah.
And make sure their house look beautiful.
Yeah.
And you take care of inside of people too.
That's right, correct.
Make sure you see what's going on, talk to people, and try to help them to make sure they can, I'm trying to figure out what I can use. Like, make sure everybody can come, go over their problems, something like that?
Yes, that's what it is. People, we want our houses, our place, our living place to be homey, like you say, comfortable living. So we want to change it, like improve it. But also, one thing I figure out over the year, you know, we can figure the outside. We try to fix the outside, but the inside is most important. Inside, we let it go. So we change the home, we change the outside, we make, oh, we get tired of this house, let's fix it up a little bit. But something we just not feeling it. That's where I come in. So when I go to your home, I'm not just bring the excellence. That's where the excellence, that division of my business that I call excellence, that's the home improvement side that of my business, but I bring the excellency. Excellency is what? Is the quality of the character, the nobleness of the character that make you feel comfortable. That's what I bring to your house. That's what I do. Yes.
Wow. I'm glad you can have people like you and you can have more people like you, because it's most importantly sometimes like people always think of the outside of the thing.
Yep.
They don't really, really think about inside. But for me, to be good outside, you need to be good inside.
That's right. That's right. We had a we had a backlog for over a long time. Whatever we need to do is already inside. And doing this, I'm going to talk about also the creator God, if you don't mind me talk. I say, when God created you, whatever we need to do, what we need to do in this life is already inside of us. So our journey through this life is found out. That's why we find the good church of biblical Bible, to get that desire out. And so we can take care of it. When we take care of it, we really, really know what we want outside, what we want it done, when we're done. You see, people bounce to this. Oh, this, I want this today. That's the outside. Let me make my house. They're still not happy.
Yeah.
And they do, they're still not happy. Why? Something's missing. They haven't connect to that, what God put inside them, that desire, that one thing that inside. That's where I come. That's why even, I don't know, not to jump ahead. That's what this book, the book came about, to help share that, you know what, do you have something inside of you that you only you can do, only you can fulfill, only you can fulfill. So find it, how you go about it. That's what it is. Yeah.
Okay. And also, you know, people think African, where they come from, like I'm trying to change this mindset of people,
yeah,
especially people who live in America.
Yeah.
And people, because we live in here, we got friends from this country.
Yeah.
You know, the thing I like about this country is kind of, you don't need to do a, like, to go to all the country in the world,
yeah,
to know people. Mm-hmm. Being living here,
yeah,
at least you know people from all over the place, yeah, by living only in this country.
Correct.
Because everybody lives in this country.
Mm-hmm.
But the people, every time when the media show stuff about Africa,
yeah,
what they show is disease, war, people, children dying,
yeah,
and stuff like that. And be African, be coming from African country,
yeah,
when you see that, every time the media, even I know I'm not the only person.
Yeah.
People come to you and talk about that.
Yeah.
Like in Africa, you got only disease, you got this, that. When people come to you, talk to you about that, what do you think and what do you tell them? Because my go-to is like to close this gap between,
yeah,
us.
Mm-hmm.
Because people don't know. Yeah. And most of the time, when the West media put on TV or put on the internet, people saw, they think about, oh, I can't go to Africa. I remember one of my coworkers, okay, told me he can't go to Africa because they got war in Africa. I said, what part of, yeah, Africa is war? I said, no, that's not true.
Yeah.
What do you think when people talk to you about that?
Well, you're right that in this country is a great country, and I'm proud of to be in it, and so you too, because we all come from, like you say, Togo, to be part of this great country, and we're part of it. And like you say, it is true. I've been... since I've been in this country, sometimes you get to talk to people. People come to you. They don't know where you're from. Even my country, Togo, they don't even know where Togo is.
Sometimes it's too small.
Yeah, it's very small little country. But think okay, the island, the island. But Togo, well, like you said, Togo is in Africa, West African country, and it is a French. So when you see our accent a little bit, it is because we had that kind of French accent in us. So that's right. So that's where it is. But the thing is, you bring something very important, the media. First of all, we had to understand what the media is and what they don't. The media want to show the news. They want to, their purpose in the news, what are going to sell. They are in business too. So we sell the bad news sales more. That's my view about it. Yeah. And yeah. what they do is they focus on that. But really, Africa is a great, when you go there, Africa has a great people and great places you can be, no war at all. Yeah, it's only a few countries, yes, when you look into it, yeah, you have a war everywhere. So Africa is a really beautiful place and have a lot, is a continent.
Even in, about the war, even in Chicago, some area in Chicago is worse than Africa.
Yeah. It is, but that's what it is. That's what we portray, the place that is a place of war, because we hear in old Zambia, you know, in Zambia or Zaire, or Liberia. So those made the news international, because when you look at, I don't want to get into that, but when you look into what happened in there, because you have a lot of countries, Western, like you say, involved in that. So it make Western news. But really, in Africa, well, it's not a place of war. It's a place, people that go to Africa, people go to Safari and all that. Even Togo, yeah, still is a beautiful place, place to go, and you see it. At one point, what we call in French, la source d'Afrique, right? Yeah. Hey, no matter la what, la source d'Afrique, it's still la source d'Afrique. Yeah. If you want, right, go in Togo. It doesn't matter what the government is, unless this is there. It's a land you can be. It is a fun place to be. Okay,
free to be,
and you have a vision. You want to relax, go there, and you have Ghana next to it. Yeah. You can go if you're American and you are English.
Go
you
to gotta Ghana.
Go to Ghana and have
go
some
to Nigeria.
Go to Nigeria.
We got plenty.
We got plenty, and feel free to challenge yourself, learn a new language. Yeah. Go to Togo or Benin, yeah. And don't be afraid. They're not gonna buy. They will love you. They will love you and cherish you. That's what we do. That's African mentality.
Yeah.
And forget
it. Lovely people.
Lovely people. That's what it is. And if you are those kind of people that listen to, you know, get the media, like, well, it's okay to do it. But also think of it. It's also a good people in Africa. It's a wonderful place to be. And look into it. Search yourself. Don't take it, you know, the wholesale. You know, do your own research about whatever country you want to go and make your decision. And that's how we tell. Don't listen to the news, though. Even what we gave you, okay? It's okay to go, you know, research what we're telling you.
Yeah.
Do your own research and make your own decision.
Do your homework.
Thank you. That's the problem.
Homework,
yeah, and make that decision. Like say, Africa is a great place and great people. And also, I think Africa is the richest continent. Really.
That's true. Everybody know that.
Everyone know that.
Even they want to admit that, they know it.
Africa is the richest continent. But if your questions are why you're poor, that's another subject that we can talk another day, because if you start that, we won't get it.
If you're going to start talking about Africa, I don't think you can, even 2 years, you can't finish
it. We can finish it.
Yeah.
When it comes to people, students, like, yeah. Well, we know all of those. So, yeah, that's what it is. Yes.
You have to talk about this. I'm so glad. I'm so happy to have this.
Yeah.
Can you talk to me about your book?
All right, yes. Really, like I said, when I was creating my business, FEM Entreprises, you know, I grew up, like you said, I grew up in a family, great family, and, you know, you're my cousin, your uncle were a pastor, and father put great in us, how we to live life of purpose. And I'm always, you see, I want to, like you, we all went to business school to get, you know, get our degree. And I always want to be a businessman. Plus that, I believe I have a message in this. So I just want to go there and just be one of them. Okay, I do home improvement, make, you know, it's not, I have another message that. And that's what I'm doing. I said, what's my message in the world? That's what this come in. I'm always inspired. Look, our family is all come to wisdom. That's what, you know, you know that we are wisdom. We all have something, learn something, teaching. And that's where it is. And as I'm creating this business, I was like, you know what? I have a message. And that's the message. And I'm when I look at this book, Seven Step Switches to Excellency, like I said earlier, we all have something inside of us that we all need to get out. And even growing up, I see a lot of people, young adults, don't know what they want out of life. And I see it even come to this great country, and I see a lot of people even get to old, don't even know what you want out of life, they don't know. And they bounce, we bounce from place to place. We follow people because this person do it. And okay, what do you really
want? Your purpose.
Yeah, your purpose. What is your purpose?
Your purpose in life.
Yes, what really excites you? What do you think? Because like I said earlier, we all go to school to be educated person. And one of the definitions, I would like to go to the origin of certain word, the word education, educo, come for draw from me, draw in. That telling you something, God has put something inside of you, which you desire. And for me, come with a seven step, the book Seven Step Switches, is a way to let you know, draw out that desire, that and live that quality in life. When you do, your desire is your direction in life. Your direction in life. When you have a direction, when you live to come, I'm glad to have you and your family in my home. You come, you have a direction, you see the direction, you come into my place. You didn't let anything else distract you. No. Even if you have a roadblock, you find a way to go around it. No. That's what it is. So when you have a destination, that desire, even you will get to it no matter what. You will be more focused. We won't be worry about what people think, what this thing, and get to think that not benefits you. That's where it is. So that's the book really.
If I'm trying to get what you're saying, is like, first step is to find your purpose in life.
Yes.
And then when you find your purpose in life, you have to find the way to get there and focus.
Focus on it, yeah. That's where, this book is going to have the seven step switch. It's going to have, like I say, I say seven step switch to excellency. Excellency, when you get to that excellency, excellency is the quality of life, the joyful, peaceful, that joy, that's the life I call life of excellency. You know, you want to get there, but how you get there, you got to find what you, that desire, what you need. You got to do something that you love, something that you want to get up every day and do it. When you do that, you fulfill that, you're going to be all joyful in it. And it's all got to come with a mind, proper mind set, you know, that's how it is. So I came out with this book to help you guide you. I'm not telling you anything. This book, that's why I made it small. I can expand to this, but I make it small for a reason. So you know that you have to do your own work. I just give you a bullet point here. Like in the book, I say switch, like when you look at after, I say switch one, for example. Cleanse your words. You see, what as a person, what we say, our words have a power.
Yeah.
You can go tell yourself all the negative thing about yourself. You just not. You can get whatever you're going, where you're going, without cleansing that. You have some kind of sense of your word, what you want. Your word got to be a focus direct to what you want. You got to cleanse your world. You can't be so negative. Some people you talk to, they're bad people. They tell you all about it. That's what it is. And that's the switch one if you look into it. And the switch one is not that long either. I put it simple. Mm-hmm. Cleanse your world. Be positive in life. Life is made about positive. And yes, there is negative. Yeah. I know.
And you have to find a way to take advantage of everything.
Yeah, that's right.
You have to change your mind.
That's right. The life is in the negative and the positive. I explained this by using the battery. Battery have a plus and negative.
Yep.
Yeah, you got to have both to work.
To work, yeah.
But you got to have more positive to have it work.
To impact the negative one.
Yeah. Yep. So you got to have it. That's how it is. That's where you got to find something. It got to be a positive in life. That's how it is. That's the book. It's about. And when you go there, switch to. And when you start doing that, have a date with yourself.
Yeah.
some people that already read the book and I have a few reviews about it and talk about it. So they take a little jokely, which is for have a date. How can I have a date with myself? I just put it in this way so you can have a time for yourself. Yeah. I never see anybody ever
achieve that. I had to work on that one.
Yeah, have a time alone by yourself.
I don't have time for myself.
Yes, you gotta find a time to have alone, to be in tune with who you are. Like I say, whatever you need to do is already inside of you. Have a time for yourself. Not to think all the day, like I say, you say, when you do the switch one, when you go to switch to have a time, you say, you don't have any time to think about all the negative. Find some to love who you are as a person. That's how you are grow. And the switch going on to switch three, you know, switch three and four and five to seven. You know, like I said, switch three is a find that desire. And when you start doing that, you see your mind, it become clear. When you clear the negative, you know how to stand time from your mind becoming clear. What you really want out of life, pop.
And where my followers can find your books?
Right now, the book, you can get the hard copy. You can order in my website. www.fementreprises.com, okay. And we have a landing page. You can order that. We have.
We're gonna put that on the screen. Your website. Then people can
order the book from there. And also, this idea is a message to the world. So I'm doing right now to keep the cost low as much possible. So my company is the publisher. So we own the publishing. So we right now, if you want a hard copy yourself, if you can get there, I have a place in East Windsor that you can pick up a hard copy there. We're gonna put the address here. And also in Manchester, you can get the hard copy.
Okay.
And the ebook part of it is coming. Is not completed. It's done. But we'll be still working with it. Going to be in Barnes & Noble. That you can get it also
in ebook. Amazon?
Not in the Amazon yet. Where? It'll be in a Barnes & Noble. Barnes & Noble website. So it should be done as soon as possible. It's almost done. We just work on the few preliminary things to make it available as an ebook. You can get it. It's just fantastic. You will love it.
And also, people want the book. If they read to me, I can easily read to Femi and get you a copy too.
Yes.
I can do that too.
Yes.
And how much the book?
How much? The book is
$11.99.
Okay. Yeah. About $12. The book, you can get it. It's $11.99 and okay. On those places. And a new plan, my goal also is work on with Barnes & Noble to get the hard copy there. So we still discuss on the price. If you get it through Barnes & Noble, the price might go up a couple dollars, I think. So it will, when it all said and done, about $13.99, that's what we should work. But I'm still negotiating on that. But the ebook at this point is going to be $9.99. At this one, and we have a few promotions going on. You may even get a little cheaper, the ebook side, but it's gonna be, that's what it is. You will get it. But at this time, it is when you, whatever you order directly through my website, or you go to those marketplace that we will give you, put it in for you, you will get it at this point. $11.99, $12. So, and I tell you, you won't go wrong and purchase this. This, and trust you, it will change your way you view life and everything else. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's what.
Femi, I'm so glad I got this opportunity to talk to you. And what can be your last word for my followers?
My friend, you are in great channel. And I know this man for a while. We grew up together, and you're always an entrepreneur and I have a great thing to say. And he even now know he inspired me. Another time we can have what we call is like a family joke. I have a lot of story about this, how entrepreneur, yeah, these guys is, we have grown up together, some of the things that this man can do. And if he create this channel and it's out of his heart, he see the need. When there's a need somewhere, and it need the decision to be made and something to be done, he's there and he's doing it. And I'm very proud of him for having this channel. And also, I'm very proud to be here. I'm honored to be in this channel. So my friend, life is what we make of it. And we've been blessed with this life. It is a blessing, and especially to be in United States. Doesn't matter if even if you're in third world country, like you say, you listen to it and you can speak English in third world country. Even my country, Togo, we are blessed with a life. This is a beautiful life, and we have a power, believe it or not, to change, to do it. And it's all up to us what we want to do. Yes, we have a lot in our control that we can do. We cannot control outside. A lot of can go out, you know, out of our way, but we still have a power. That's where it comes to. But you have to decide that and choose life. That's where they choose life. Choose to live life and clear or simplify life for yourself. And what most important thing, love. Love it all. Like we say, it's not, it's just about love. Love to live that life. And when you start love life, you clear yourself of all some of those little things. They say 99% of the things we worry, your worry doesn't happen. Yeah. Focus on what you want in life, what you really love, and do it. You will see that you see love in the people. And briefly, if you allow me to do, I just ran Manchester Road Race.
Yeah, I saw you yesterday.
Yes, I just ran Thursday. Yeah. And usually, when the race is done, I just clean up because at one point I was the year passed. I support one organization, so we set a table. So I don't just clean up, focus on clean up. But this, due to COVID, everything, I just went run by myself. When I was done with it, I step back and watch go to the end. I was done way earlier than myself. So I was watching people crossing by, all walks of life. People, parents, people, grandchildren running, and they talk, come to me. People, when people have direction in life, want something they focus on, they don't care about anything else. Everybody that you can, they all, even they don't, it doesn't matter what color it is, race, background, whatever, they're all supporting. It's all support because they all come goal. Their goal is running the race. Yeah. People are more nicer when they have a purpose in life. Yeah. That's the purpose they came into it. Find that purpose. People are more nice. I never see anybody say anything negative. We see people crying, people say, nobody comes in insults. And everybody was so nice atmospheres. Everyone encouraging. So this is my last word for you. Find something that you really passionate about and go after, and you will see that, you know what, you'll never go wrong. Your life will never be the same again. You'll find things good about people. Thank you.
Thank you, Femi. Yeah. I'm so glad we got this discussion with Femi about what he's doing. That's good, and like I said, time to time you have to go to some African folks, and even some American folks who would like to share what they're doing, and to close the gap. My goal is to close this gap between those two communities. What people say to you, and what is the reality, you need to know that. You need to go to people, listen to them, they're going to tell you their reality, then you can focus your mind and know what it is. Don't just judge people without knowing them. That's the problem we got in our community. And we need to close that gap. That's going to be me. That's going to be you. We have to do it. And Femi, I'm so happy you give me this opportunity to talk about you. And I know we're gonna have more and more coming.
Yeah.
And today we just, it's kind of introduction. I'm gonna say like, I'm gonna tell that, I'm gonna call that like that. And I can come to your job one day like I used to do. And see how you do in your workplace too.
Yeah.
And if you got a friend from our community, we like to share what they're doing.
Yeah.
I think people would like to know and we like to see what about Africa, what we are and what we're doing. And how we live in this country.
Yeah.
And I think that's a good thing to do and to show to people, to show to our folks, to show to our friends what it is. And even people in Africa can see the life we're living over here and they can have idea. They don't let them think like everything's okay. You have to work for it.
Yeah.
You have to work for it.
Yeah.
We live in here or you live outside here, you have to work for it.
Yeah.
Set up your mind, focus, and everything will be okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And I believe this is now, like, we have a lot to
I know we have a lot to say.
Let's keep it there. And feel free to contact me anytime. I'll be glad to do whatever, any thought, any idea, believe me, I'm ready for it. And thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.